2015015.
Your mic is now lifted up.
For this speech he delivered graciously. I will start by making few corrections. The honorable from Tonkolili, my 91 to be specific, I could to be one of my best students. In fact, he scored A in macroeconomics, you know, during the days of this time. But unfortunately today, as far as the fair issue is concerned, they did not use the concept of PPP, purchasing power parity, which I'm sure he knows what I'm talking about. Yeah, at the same time, the food security formula too, he did not look at it properly. No, I will give you tea. I also want to draw the attention of the other honorable from the other honorable from Potloko about the benefits as far as those teachers that have taught for 30 years receive, 10 years and above receive. I want to draw your attention to the report from the Ministry of Education that in 2018-2019, 90 teachers who have taught for 10 years and above benefited from the SLE. 90 teachers benefited from that one. And for that same period, 114 security personnel, 40 military, 62 police, and 12 prisoners benefited from the SLE. In 2018-2019 school year, academic year, out of the 5,112 people who applied online, plus 400 who applied using the hard copy, 2,704 benefited from the SLG. 200 from undergraduate, 400 for TVET, 25 benefited from the PhD student benefited, and 25 master student also benefited. That number increased in 2019-2020 to 2,900. In 2021, this current academic year, 2020-2021, I want to inform this house that the Minister of Technical and Higher Education has received up to 16,125 applicants. So I all want to use this forum to appeal to the Minister of Education to please increase the number of scholarship facilities that you are going to award to the university students this time. When we look at the international scholarship from 2019-2020 up to date, 374 students Sierra Leoneans have benefited from international scholarship. Among them, 705,000 United States dollars in 12 countries, ranging from Venezuela, China, Tunisia, in Pakistan, Morocco, etc., etc. So hopefully, we are about to increase this number to 500. That is the intention of the ministry. 500 Sierra Leoneans may likely benefit from this particular international scholarship, this academic. So we want to encourage the government to ensure that these benefits are cut across all the regions.
Why be they condemn parliament?
Yeah. Then the issue of Limkokwing. Somebody mentioned about Limkokwing. I want to inform you that meetings have been held between the Minister of Education and that of the Minister of Finance, and the issues have been brought to rest. They've already agreed on payment plan, which they are going to work with. we to pay to ensure that what is due for them are going to be paid. So I will just take you briefly to the economy, because I will be remiss in my statement if I don't talk a bit about the economy. So I will go straight to page 12.
Talk about taxation.
I will talk about the economic diversification and promoting economic growth and development.
Don't forget
the change of page. Government decided to diversify the economy. Remember, in the president's initial speech, he had already told you that he was going to diversify the economy. Instead of us relying on the traditional sources of income for the economy, the government decided to move the economy to through fisheries, agriculture, and tourism. Yeah, so you now notice that from January alone to May, government has benefited 52 billion from fisheries. That one accounts for 12% of the GDP. Also from agriculture, government has benefited 53%. Agriculture has contributed 53% to the GDP in 2020. And also government has contributed, agriculture has contributed 54% of the employment.
So what about the minerals?
So government really hopes to increase the contribution of agriculture in terms of employment to 86% in the next 3 years. Government also have put in a prudent financial management strategy which have been implemented by the Minister of Finance and the Bank of Sierra Leone. If you check on page 9 of this document, you will notice that government is now implementing the TSE, that is the Treasury Single Account. Government has also introduced the credit bureau system. They are also promoting long-term lending to businesses to moderate interest rates. They developed a modern credit, the collateral and registration, including ID. They are allowing commercial banks to do digital financial services. Also report that the special credit facility were introduced last summer at the height of the COVID.
Inflation
has reduced to we are really inflation very close to one digit. We are very close to one digit now. At one digit. When I say one digit, it's from 0 to 9.
You have a minute to wind up.
Okay, quickly, there are also several reforms undertaken by the public financial management. That is the public financial management, including the NRA. NRA has moved from Asiguda Plus Plus to Asiguda World. They have automated the revenue collection system. They are rolling out electronic public expenditure tracking platform. They have also established those registers. Electronic registers, which most of the businesses are now benefiting from. So anytime you go in particular, you go to a particular big supermarket also, please ask for your receipt. Because they have introduced any purchase.
Not to the introducer. Not to the introducer.
Thank you very much. So this has increased the revenue of NRA by almost threefold. Which government all of us are benefiting. That is why we know that there is no delay. I want to conclude by encouraging us that we are about to review the 2005 University Act to ensure that they bring on board other three public universities that are technical universities. All of us know that the government, the other universities are overwhelmed with the introduction of this free quality education because the demand is now greater than to also be able to absorb that one, government has decided to create these three universities. We are hoping to transform them into Magai College University very soon. We are also hoping to transform the Eastern Polytech to a technical university. And now we already know that the Kono University is almost at the part of the establishment. So this act will be brought to Parliament very soon. I want to crave your indulgence as Romanians for us to be able to ensure that this 2005 Act, when brought to the Parliament, hopefully anytime, let us all support it in the interest of the country so that we can be able to absorb all these people to post the economy. Most Bamba already has a college. Most Bamba already has a college, master college of Bamba. So the rest are sure. I want really to for all of us to put our efforts together so that when this act is brought to Parliament, anytime from now, we support it too. That government can be established before the end of this year, so that.